are proceeding, and none other than this evening, we got Man Night official Sanzi in the building. What are you saying, Sanzi, my doggy? How are we?
I'm very tired, bro. I've missed that air for an hour. What are you joking? I'm feeling good, man.
I feel like that's your excuse to be like, yo, I'm just going to have to come back again, man, and we're going to have to do it another time.
Yeah,
still,
yeah.
Of course, man. Yo, it's nice to have you in the building. We're finally on air, we're ready to go, and I'm looking forward to talking about yourself, the projects you've got going, and kind of what, I think the right turn of phrase is what you do for the community in hip-hop in Manchester, because I feel like you have an important place and played an important part in what we do in this scene, in this culture, and for the music that we love. So we're going to get into a few of your tracks tonight, I believe.
Yeah, we are. Take It Back, man.
And we're going to get into a few of some other tracks that you brought with us, of people that you've worked with, people that have passed through Lab 51.
Yeah, some of the ones that have stood out to me over the years. I mean, I didn't have time to dig too deep. There's plenty on there, but there's a couple that really stood out. So a couple of my favourites are in there.
Okay. So for anyone who's locked and loaded with us right now, like, and maybe hasn't heard of Sanzi or Lab 51 and what you guys do over there, can we give them a brief introduction as to what you're about, what goes on?
So, obviously me, I'm an artist. I was an artist, still am. I don't know, man. Never can consider myself one anymore. I make music from time to time.
Okay.
As for Lab 51, it's a Manchester-based platform. Obviously, we look out for a lot of the up-and-coming talent, established talent. We do the podcasts, you know, shows, small events within the studio. And we're just built on genuine ground, man, helping the young ones through, you know, putting on where we can, put on as we get on. Like, just the typical from your ground up platform, bro, that what, likes to give a little summer back.
What came first, the artist or the studio?
The artist, bro. So, obviously, as Sanzi, I was rapping for years. And to be honest with you, bro, I got to a point where I started getting that, where you lose your love a little bit. I was struggling to write,
right, okay. But
I still wanted to be, you know, in the music. And I felt like I was a bit old. I know that seems stupid. But I don't think I am now, I look back, obviously that's why I started recording a lot again, but yeah, man, but I still wanted to be in the mix. So yeah, man, I just jumped on the studio side of things. It was originally just a studio, bro, in a mill, and it was a corner where I thought, I want to film in that corner, wrapped it in hazard tape, because it was an old pillar in the corner, you know, like the old mills have them supporting pillars, wrapped it in hazard tape, Hacienda style, Lab 51, Fat 51, the Hacienda, kept it mank. And yeah, man, took it from there, bro.
That's how you have to start, Rago style like that, I think, in anything you do, especially in the hip-hop kind of community. So, I suppose this is going to be quite a difficult question if you can answer it, but what do you prefer? Do you prefer being an artist or do you prefer running a studio?
Running a studio is hard work, bro. To be honest with you, you know yourself, dealing with people day to day, artists and whatnot.
Artists.
You lot, man. I'm an artist myself, so I know I can't be hard work at times as well. But yeah, man, probably I'd say the artist, bro, because that's my first love. As a rapper, that's who I am. Everything else is just spanned from that.
Yeah, I suppose being an artist, part of it is being in the studio and doing the studio thing, and go hand in hand, really, innit?
They work hand in hand, and like I say, because of the studio now, starting as an artist, it's given me a lot of experience. It's helped me run a studio a lot better.
Yeah, I can imagine. True, I didn't think about that.
Because me as an artist, I know when I've been studios, when I've been on the come up in the past, trying to do this, that and whatnot, there's a lot of doors to try and get through, do you know what I mean? So if you can open them for an upcoming artist, I'm going to do that. I mean, I've not got the most links, but I'll share the ones I have in it. Like, say, put on as a gap, and then I'll help out where I can. Because it is being an artist, bro.
I think the right person, helping out the right person at the right time, like, is part of your duty in this community. Because each one teach one is one of the same
things we
have here, isn't
definitely.
It? Like, each one teach one. So to have that mentality is important, but still, there has to remain like a little bit of selectivity with it.
No, of course, quality control.
Yeah, I
believe everyone should get a shot. If they like to do the music, I'll give them an opportunity, but comes a point where you have to start tightening up on quality, bro, if you want people to engage.
Yeah, this is
and just while we're on it, bro, Lab 51 was actually born a couple of weeks today.
Oh,
I realised, yeah, it was September. September we created the channel a lot before I come on, 4 years ago. September the something, we'll call it now, today.
Lab 51, so how many years is it?
Four years, bro.
Four years.
I like that, innit? It's gone quick, man.
I can imagine, man. 4 years sounds quicker than. Sounds longer than it should be, you know what I mean? Sometimes when you look back 4 years, you think, wow.
It's my day, it was yesterday. But as well, bro, saying that, the channel was created then, it took me how long to set up the studio and that, so it would have been a few months after, and the first upload and whatnot. But yeah, man, we'll just call it 4 years.
And you must be happy with what you've achieved over 4 years on that channel, man.
Yeah, definitely. I'm happy. I'm not where I want to be yet, but La51's become my baby, my project. I enjoy it, do you know what I mean?
I can see it, man. I think anyone who knows you can see it, and it's apparent. Yeah, speaking of La51, one of the latest tracks that you put out there as an artist, I believe, is Lab Sessions Part 2.
Yeah, it is. So Lab Sessions Part 2.
We're going to get into it. I feel like we should get into it and give the listeners a little taste of what you've brought to the table this evening.
Yeah, man.
So, Lab Sessions Part 2, this is one of the series on La51.
Yeah, Lab Sessions is one of the series, one of the ones we're most known for.
And this is your Part 2
from the channel. Yeah, Samzy, Lab Sessions Part 2 off the channel.
Who produced the beat for this?
Mike Wizard, Mike Wizard on this one. I forgot for a second. And Mike Wizard produced Mike Part 2, yeah.
Yeah, I'm sure there's a lot of people out there that know of Mike Wizard and know who he's a staple of the community for a long time.
Mike Wizard's hard, man. He's good at what he does.
So, official Samzy Lab Sessions Part 2. This is the first of many that we're going to get into this evening. Unity Radio 92.8 FM. Sounds of Breaks Radio Show.
Don't believe me, go chase it. I did my bit, rid my bird, play with fire, caught my burns, play with guns, play with knives, used them over countless times. Made some fools, lost some friends, ducked and dive and ran from feds. Whistle off for nothing, I've had bullets whistle past my head. Brody caught a hot when I was stepping, but I heard his cries. Turned around, went back for him, I held my best friend as he cried. Held my tears, I held them tight, he whispered, Sam, don't let me die. Don't ever question my law, his pussy holes, I've earned my stripes.
Jeez, that was the first of many tonight. Official Sam's there. Lab Sessions Part 2, and that was the Samzy Lab Sessions Part 2, not the Reeks Lab Sessions Part 2.
Yeah, Reeks is coming up, bro, Reeks is coming up.
obviously, it happens though, it's nice, it's time, it's cool. We're going to get into that a little bit later on. So obviously that was the Lab Sessions Part 2. Who was the first person to do the very first Lab Session video?
Shreds.
Oh, big up Shreds, okay.
He recently done his Part 2 as well. But yeah, he was the very first person on the channel, man.
Oh, big up Shreds. I like Shreds, man. Shreds has got a high work rate level. Like, I think his lyrical ability is different, like, right now. He's like, multi-syllabic rhyming, and I believe he's doing quite well on TikTok at the moment.
He is, bro. He's nuts with it. He's very talented, Shreds. He's got his own. He's his own genre, bro. His own lane. He's different with it, man.
Yeah, 100. He's got handed 100. To him. So, obviously, La51, you must have, over the 4 year span, worked with quite a few different artists and people passing through your studio. Who's some of your most memorable sessions that you've had with there at the studio? Not even necessarily the most famous or like the most well known, like, what's one of the most memorable sessions you've had over there?
Why didn't I prepare for this? Should have known you was going to ask this. You know what, bro? It would be the memorable ones are the consistent ones, the ones that were coming regular. So there used to be a young lad called Silo. I don't know if you know about him. He's good at what he does. He used to come. His first time in the studio was with La51, so I always remember this. He was only a young kid, but he stepped in confident, bro. He stepped in the booth like he'd been doing it a very long time, and it threw me that it was his first time in the studio. When he told me, and we worked closely for a bit, man, and I watched him grow and develop. Not just as an artist, but as a young man, innit? He's got his beard and that now. Do you know what I mean? He's growing up now. So and he's doing his music for, I think he's been signed. It's nice to see. Some of my memorable moments as well will be the lab sessions lives we've done. We done one over COVID. I know we weren't meant to do it. COVID's done now. We locked the doors, we got in there, we done a lab live, bro. Someone told on us, the feds were at the door, we were all watching them on the camera. If you go on type Lab Sessions Live, New Year's Eve special. And you'll see it, bro, it's all documented. We all had to run out of the building. It was a good laugh, we was all rapping. Yeah, man, and I brought my new year in Pitt's car park in the snow. With Reeks, LT, a couple of other artists. Yeah, man, shout out to LT and Reeks and that as well. Got a few of their tracks. But yeah, that was definitely one of my memorable moments, bro, because it was funny.
I always think, like, when you're in that studio game and you're in the mode of making music with your friends and sitting down and being creative like that, some of the best music is spawned from going in and just kind of enjoying your time while you're there, and just treating it like a little get together with your friends.
Yeah,
and that's when I think sometimes the magic happens and a bit more of a relaxed state comes and the better music comes out. music's a vibe, that's what it should be.
No pressure.
That's what you aim to kind of create when you're there.
We've done a lot of sessions like that, bro, where it's writing on the spot, or you've got an old verse and you're like, right, this fits.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean?
Yeah,
another one, bro, I don't know how I forgot. We got Wiley in once.
Oh, big shout.
Shout out to Brittis and Kane, bro, because he plugged it. Wiley went to the studio in Manchester to do his Esky, his little Esky dance, you know, his live thing he does. Mm-hmm. Is that what it's called? It isn't it?
Yeah, Esky boy, like Esky
dance. That thing he does. And he just tweeted me like we spoke an hour ago and he was my mate. Yes, bro, what's happening? I'm going to ring you soon. I was like, right, this is Wiley. Do you know what I'm saying? Come to the studio, humble as you like, cool as fuck, bro. Got his DJ down, bro. I felt like as I was at like a more intimate mini concert, bro. He's doing all the tracks we know. Do you know what I mean? We went mad. We was only about 15, 20 of us in there, but we hit the roof. Reeks got up there and done Fuck the Police, one of his well-known songs, a bassline song. Why he was going mad to that, because he didn't realise it was Reeks. Bro, it was just a mad experience, and I've listened to this guy on the back of school buses, bro. Do you know what I mean? So to have him in the building, and then, yeah, man, funny enough, recently in the new building, we had flipping Flirt D in there, bro, another one off the D500s at the back of the school bus, and he's in there giving it his flipping, I can't even describe his style, but yeah, giving it some, do you know what I mean?
Yeah, I can imagine.
Shutting
can
down,
imagine.
Bro.
And it's sometimes like, when you see them set guys like you say that you used to listen to back on the school bus, like, when you see them in the studio now and they're still going in and they're going hard, it shows you the reason why who they were when they were back then, like who they were, that person.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying?
Of course. It's mad, bro. These men are still at it, bro. Vets, that's why they're vets, bro.
100 million%. The skill level's just different. It's higher. There's a different echelon, and you can see why they turn into legends like that.
No, yeah, of course.
Big up Wiley.
It's been mad, bro. The lab's been mad. It's been on my journey, bro.
Yeah.
I told you on the podcast, didn't it, when we done that 51 in 51. 51
yes.
days straight,
yes.
51 yeah. freestyles. Bro, that broke me in half, bro. I actually caught COVID during that.
That is
crazy,
man.
It was mad, bro. 51 days on the trot, I'm all over the country filming people, and it got to a point, bro, where I'm like, I need a freestyle. Who's got one? Where are you? I'm just flying about on that. Who's got bars pulling up on random kids? Let's go.
What was the latest time you got one?
Bro, like, I'm talking like touching midnight, bro. Do you know what I mean? But I got him to a system. I had the template on Premiere Pro. Just throw the audio in. Boom, let's go, export it.
Come on, right, okay.
I managed it, bro. And
We're in a safe place now. Did you double up one day, like drop it the next day?
Yeah.
It was going to be quiet.
Yeah,
double up on two.
Damn right, I did. Once or twice. Now, you know what it was? We drove out far. We was in like Sheffield and that.
We done a cypher
one day, and I got one or two in it, but I didn't capitalize off doing that or very often. Bro, 90% of the time, bro, it was every night in it.
Yeah.
It was mad, bro.
When
I got the COVID, bro, I was like, yo, you need to come to me and I'll film you up the street, because we was a bit unsure about COVID then. Is it really the fate? I know it makes you old, no one wants to get ill. And then we rounded it up with Fiasco, bro. Set it off with Foss. You know, FOS was the rap game, set off with him, ended it with Fiasco, bro, the one and all. It had to be Fiasco, bro, and he savaged the mic, bro.
Cold.
Went in, you know how Fiasco gets started.
Yeah, 100%.
So, yeah, it was a perfect ending, bro, and, bro, I was so happy to see the back of it.
Right. You know
what I mean?
So, no more plans for, like, part two of that series?
Bro, if we do it again, I'll be cheating all the way through, probably that way. I'm not doing that again.
Serious. Yo, so I feel like we should get into some more tracks right now. I feel like we should get into, which we're going to play Reeks' Lab Sessions Part 2.
That's his part 2,
Again, Reeks' Lab Sessions Part 2. These are all shot kind of in the same space, I believe, in your studios there with the background, with the TV kind of in the background, all in the same setting. Is that something that you would open up to anybody that would want to come and do a lab session? Or is that kind of more selective of... Do you shout people and contact them and bring them in?
So with the lab sessions, we have got a little bit more pickier now, selective, like you say. There has to be a time when you start, you know, knuckling down on quality control. I do believe, you know, everyone did. If you're into music, bro, and you want to rap, bro, someone, why not do it? You're venting, that's what it's about. Anyway,
yeah,
to vent, just because you're not the tightest on the mic yet, don't mean you won't get there. So now I'll encourage them to, like, right, this is what we'll do. We'll give lab sessions a miss. Let's do one of these, or let's do a straight in, or go away and work on your craft. I try to be as honest as I can without offending people, innit? Because we do need to, you know, keep the quality. It's important, bro.
Yeah, yeah.
Massive,
so.
And yeah, also with the TVs, the lab sessions were always like that. Like say, it used to be the black and yellow pillar, and this is, so this is off the old series. Right. So if you did find it online, you'd see the old set, but everything here, but it's all over the lab and that. But yeah, I mean, anyone's you know, a welcome on the channel, is what I'm trying to say. Like, whether you're a vet or just starting, we'll have something of somewhat to help you out. Yeah. Even if we might chat at you and say, bro, you need to be on the other side of the camera with me, but you can still get involved
in it.
Well,
I hear that.
Do you know what I mean?
Some people need that constructive criticism just to be like, oh, this is what you need to work on. Mm-hmm. I get music sent left, right and centre, like to the station for the show for people to say, oh, can you play this? And you know, if they come correct with the way they're bringing it to the table and it's still not radio worthy, like,
yeah,
I was like, well, let them know why the mixing needs a little bit, or the mastering, or just look at the beat, like have a little look at bringing the quality back up if you can,
yeah.
and then we'll see kind of if they come back, if you're like, okay, take this on board, let's try and throw it back, or if we never hear from them again, then
like
that.
No, yeah, I'm sorry about that. A lot of them will take it well. What I will say as well, for anyone listening, because there's this whole thing about rappers, yeah, but they're cat rappers, and I don't care who's real and who's fake. If you're a good rapper, it's irrelevant to how honest you are in your lyrics. Do you know what I mean? We don't discriminate. If you can rap, you can rap, even if you're talking rubbish. If you're the realest rapper on road, but you can't rap, bro, think, you know, sorry, mate.
Right, okay,
do you know what I mean?
Okay.
Sorry. It has nothing to do with real and fake.
Yeah.
A lot of them have said that, yeah, but these guys are capping them. Bro, you can't rap, bro.
I think, obviously, do you know what I mean? There's a level of entertainment to it, and there's a level of storytelling to it. I think it has to be clear, the line has to be clear cut if you kind of go down that route. But we're going to get into the next one right now. You may have heard what, a second or two of it earlier on, but we're going to get into it right now. This is Reeks Lab Sessions Part 2, Unity Radio, DJ by Adam Reeks Radio Show.
Yeah, you're weak there. We were baby for your street, leased off a gang related estate. Originals LSE, L Town turned to LA. Coming out of Hell's Gates, bridges had no bail dates. Tune account with cellmates, map of free restrictions. Bag of IPPs, the convictions. Judges throwing books about some problem causing picnics. These days, they're influenced by Mozzie and them niggas. Brains foot to listening to provenance to sickness.
Jeez, sounds of Reeks. Lab Sessions Part 2. Oh, big shout. So have we got more to come from the lab sessions this evening, or is that...
Let me look.
Is that how we're opening it, two lab sessions, and then kind of like, right, now we're going to give you some...
We've got a couple more, but I'm not going to give them you all. Like, we've got a couple, like, you know, music video submissions, audio uploads. Yeah, I've got a couple here, man. I know what we're going with next.
Okay.
It away from Reeks and Sam's, innit? We come together anyway, so it's like... Like I'm just playing myself twice there.
Right,
do you know
right,
what I'm saying?
Right,
everyone
yeah,
links
yeah,
us in it, so
yeah, yeah.
We'll go elsewhere in a second.
Well, it's an introduction to you anyway, this
yeah,
live show. So
true.
Of course we're gonna hear from you first.
Yeah.
But Lab 51, obviously when I think of Lab 51, I think of Sam Z. I think of Lab 51. To me, they are one and the same, you know.
So
to hear kind of your track supported on your channel, and then see it opening up with so many other people passing through and coming supporting. I like the fact that the channel has so many different elements to it, so many different arms. It's not just a platform for a freestyle. It's here's a music video, here's a podcast, and not even necessarily just music. It can change around different themes, different topics, just whatever's kind of relevant or interesting to yourself and the audience that you're broadcasting to. I think one person I'd like to give a shout out who I think also is doing good things for the grind community, and you know, I don't know what I'm going to say, is Walsh.
Very, very, very good. Walsh is my guy, man.
Treehouse Manchester.
I love
people that are kind of doing these elements of community groups to keep the culture alive.
Mm-hmm.
What made you kind of want to start that in the first place? Was it the fact that you just wanted to get a studio and create music, or did you have an idea of, okay, I want to create a studio that puts out freestyles, interviews, music videos?
Do you know what? It was like, it was just one of them things. I think once you're on ice, there'll become a time when you want your own studio, and you'll have it in your head, oh, I'm gonna have LED lights and all these buttons that I don't know what half of them do. Do you know what I mean? But the studio looks smart. Do you know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
and I'm gonna break the bank buying loads of equipment that never gets used.
100.
So yeah, man, that was kind of the beginning of it, bro. And like I say, I was going through that little thing, like, am I getting a bit old to be an artist? I'm a bit funny, me, but one minute I'll be committed to my work, I do construction, I'll be like, yeah, I'm all in with this. And then someone will say, what are you doing, bro? Like, you can rap in it, like, this is what you need to be doing. But I like to do both in it, why not? It's another thing, yo, you can work and rap, guys, it's all right, man. You don't have to hide from the work. Work 100. Will get you the studio time, bro. Do you know what I mean? 100%. Music's costly, bro. Go to work, fund your shit the right way, and you'll stay out here to reap the benefits of it, innit?
Do you know what one of my friends told me once, Sam, and he said, it made so much sense when he said it. He said, think of the guys that go playing football for their local pub on a Sunday. Like, them guys know they're never going to make it in the Premier League. Cause they know they're never going to be the next Ronaldo or whatever. Like, same. Some people make music because we're not trying to be like the next Dr. Dre. Exactly. We don't want to be like,
I agree,
it'd be nice if it did happen, don't get me wrong, and a track got took and went and did different things, you know what I mean, and put you in a different
place. It's a bonus, sorry, yeah.
But that's not the reason why we do it because we love it.
We enjoy it.
And I thought it was such a great way to put it.
It is, bro. I've said the same thing before, like, not everyone goes gym because they want to be the next, they're going to keep fit, they enjoy it, it's a way of them. Sometimes, bro, it's all about the mental, bro, they're going because they're flipping, trying to keep steady up top. Same with music. You can hear it in a lot of people's music. They're literally, they're venting in it, they're reaching out, crying out, if you listen. Obviously, I think we've got to a stage now, though, bro, where it's gone away a bit, innit? A lot of people are just rapping because it's the fashion.
You know what I mean? Yeah.
Everybody's rapping, bro. Yeah. Don't get me wrong, though, there's a lot of good rappers. I'd love to sit here and say, like, it's a lot of crap. It's not, bro. There is a lot in it. I wouldn't love to sit here and say that, but you know what I mean? Like, I get sent a lot of music and I think, oh, you actually can rap.
I fully hear that. For me, there's a few things judge is the wrong word, but there's a few things what I look out for, what I listen for when I'm listening to new music and new rappers. So the first is obviously, like, your beat selection, like, going from more of a producer point of view, like, I want to hear what type of beat you're trying to build. And then it's about what you're saying and how you say it with your lyrics.
Your delivery and whatnot.
You can have a cold beat, you can have the illest lyrics, but sometimes there's just not a vibe there as well. There's a vibe missing. So I always look for that kind of... You can't describe it, you don't know what it is.
Exactly what you're saying, bro.
I don't think I could be an artist. Being around, as you said before, there's a point like, I was around studios for a long time. We was recording, producing, around people that were jumping in the booth. Jumping the booth, man. Go and write a 16 and jump on this track. A few times thinking, do you know what?
Let's do it.
and getting confident as well. Like, I think I could, you know. I think we could do it, but I always held back. I could never jump on it because I always thought it was too personal, man.
I agree with you, bro. It's a funny one, music now, isn't it? Like you say, everyone is a rapper.
So we've had Lab Sessions Part 2 from yourself, Lab Sessions Part 2 from Reeks.
Yeah.
What's the next track we're going to run into this evening?
So now we're going to take it to a couple of my favourite artists from Manchester. I'm going to say that because not many people want to props up.
Big claim.
Artists on the same page. I'm a fan of these two here.
Big claim.
You get it? My guy A Diddy Don, we met through music, innit? And he's hard, bro, innit? He deserves the recognition, bro. I've got a lot of his music on my playlist. You know what I mean? A lot of it's on my channel. He's got skills, bro, innit? He's got talent. He's a rapper, bro.
Cold.
Poetry, cold. Storytelling. Cold. Out and out. He's got the package, and you got Donatello, one of the younger ones. He's dirty, bro, innit? Skill set, mad. He can jump about any beat. Very versatile. But these two together, yeah, madness, bro. So this one's A Diddy Don, Donatello, and it's called Freedom.
Okay. So is this one of the tracks that's been done on the studio? Is there a video hosted on the channel?
So it's just an audio upload.
Right, okay.
They was actually just sat on this track, bro, like two madmen. And I said, you got any music? We're doing this audio upload, or what? I need to throw a song on the channel so I can, you know, just see how it looks on this template I've got.
But
this song, bro, like, he's a mad. We're shooting a video to this free of charge. I'm shooting it. Yeah, they slept on this. The 2 years of you listening, you muppets. Get this one out properly. This is hard, bro.
You probably know yourself, how many documents have you watched where people have gone like, yo, this track was slept on until someone made us release it, and then it was one of the biggest tracks that they ever had.
Bro, it's hard, bro. These men annoy me when I hear it, like, yo, they're just like, it's throwaway. Nah, this is dirty, bro.
Yo, so this is what we're going in with right now. This is A Diddy Don, Freedom, featuring Donatello. Unity Radio 92.8 FM in the building with Lab 51. Man, like,
I just want to invest, buy some property. Came up broke, crack fiends and poverty. Hustling to death because I ain't winning on the lottery. 10 years ago, went jail for a...
I just need you to stay. Just stay. Everybody come and goes, but don't nobody stay. Nobody told me that I lose all of my friends along the way. Losing time and losing everything like I'm supposed to be okay. Like I'm supposed to be fine, cause this shit happens every day. Should I just ignore my demons, hoping they'll just go away?
It sounds like A Did It Done. That was called Freedom featuring Donatello. Okay, okay. So Samzy, I hear you.
Hey,
you
feel it?
Yo, Samzy, I hear you.
It's happening.
I hear you.
They're tough, bro.
Sometimes people can create emotions within the track and people can paint a picture, and I feel like with that track you brought across then, it was definitely a track that meant a lot to A Did It Done.
Yeah, you can hear it, you can feel it.
Sometimes you just hear it in it, that's one of those tracks, so I hear you on that. Oh, no more sleeping on tracks like that, please. So
you've got it now, bro, you've got it in it, it's in your playlist.
Yeah, 100, that's definitely making an addition to it. So if you was making a Manchester playlist, who would you put in it?
Ooh, this is a hard one. So obviously, do you know what, bro? Do you know what's mad about music now, especially in Manchester?
What?
You can think you're plugged in, you're not. Do you know what I mean? So some people might disagree with me when I'm saying these names now, but bro, I'm not aware of everyone. There's a lot of artists in it. I'd put currents, like the ADD Dons, obviously Donatello, Keeks, Flipping. Couple of them Two Real type. Have you heard of Two Real Records, Micah and that?
Yeah, I've had Two Real Records on the show. So, in fact, it hit me up the other week saying he's coming through. I like Keeks as well.
Keeks is another one. Very skilled, bro. 100%. Passionate. You can hear it in his delivery and stuff. Couple of them sort of artists. But you put me on the spot now. I put some of the old boys on there, innit? Do you know the originals? Mm. You like to the Riggs and the Shifties and the Hypes. XP. XP's got to be on there, bro. XP's nuts, you know. He's coming up next, by the way.
Oh, XP is ill. His debut album recently dropped, Better Late Than Never.
Hard, bro. Goes by the name Frankie now, innit?
Yeah.
He's always going to be XP to me. Yeah. Sorry, bro, if you're listening. XP, innit? But, yeah, man. I don't know, bro, innit? It's a hard one. You put me on the spot a bit. I can only think of, like, a couple of names. I'll go away and think of those. But, obviously, if we're putting a playlist together, bro, I'd take my time with it, innit?
Yeah. And I would say, like, when you ask, like, what would you put in a playlist, like, who's your top five? Ask me today, ask me tomorrow, it's going to be different.
It's going to change, innit? You know what I mean?
So, what's next for Lab 51, then? Have we got any more kind of different types of series running? Any more kind of ideas for the channel? Or are we sticking with kind of developing what we've got for now?
So, I've been known to start trying to do too many things at once. So I have got ideas for other series, but I've sort of slowed my roll a bit. I'm focusing a lot, as you can see, on the Behind the Mic podcast at the moment. Yeah, not been running long. We've got another podcast called Reality Check, run by Mikey G. So we got them two on the road. Reality Check's more about, you know, men's mental health, women as well, but obviously as a guy, sits down with a lot of males, so that's kind of what they touch on more.
Yeah.
Just the real world, bro, innit? Do you know what I mean? You'd have to listen to me trying to explain it, but you'll get a gist of it if you had to listen to a couple of them. And Behind the Mic, very, very mixed. One day we'll have an artist, one day we'll have... Yeah, I had a guy on today who was, you know, he went to jail in Spain for being one of the biggest suppliers of, I think it was steroids and that, years ago when he was younger. Hauling him into the UK, got caught, got a mad story. So yeah, man, taking it a bit more like Minutes With from Lab Bible, you know, they get different people. But they don't really get artists on there because we're an artist-based channel, we keep it. We've got to let them on. But yeah, trying to branch out a little bit. And we've got the series on The Strip that's for more established artists. That's something we're very picky about. When you was asking before,
that's
not something you can just pop up and say, you know, we'll reach out to you. We set it off with Tiny Boost, which was a massive look for the channel.
So you've got kind of like levels to the channel. If you want to come through and work, okay, let's come through. And then if you're more established, you're more up here. Now I hear that, because people do search out for different styles and, like you say, different moves. Sometimes I'm in the mood to discover new music, want to see what new artists are out there. And sometimes I'm in the mood to sing along to what I already know.
It's easier, isn't it?
You know what I mean? Like, so I fully hear that.
Yeah, annoying.
So big up Lab 51. I think it's a great kind of like pillar of the community of what you guys do. As I said at the start of the interview, I genuinely mean that, man. More power to you. And I think the more people like yourself that have spots like this for people to be creative, to have outlets for people to showcase kind of what you've made, I think the city needs more of it, and that's the only way we go. Big up yourself, big up people like Walsh, big up Hypes doing his kind of things right now. Big up Green, the whole team. No. So let's get into some more music then, man. Let's get into another track. What should we run next?
So this we gotta go with XP now, innit? Frankie, XP, he done his Freestyle Friday thing for a bit, a few months back, leading up to his album, don't you see
it? That's right.
So we was working together, he was in the studio in London, in the city, is it London he lives? Wherever he was, somewhere up there.
I don't think it's London, no, it's somewhere,
It's not a walk, innit?
Yeah.
So yeah, he was there and he was sending me the footage, I was editing it, just quick videos, quick, just every Friday, Freestyle Friday, and bro, he never misses, bro.
Yeah.
But there's this one in particular called Karma that we're going to get into now, which is a mad one. I'd park up if you get this on because you're catching them red lights and them speeding tickets. This is mad, bro.
Yeah, XP is hard, man. He's always had that different flow and been about from day. And not only that, he's always worked with some of Manchester's legendary rappers as well. Like, he's one of them who's always been active.
Good CV, bro, in music.
So let me make sure I find the right one.
It'll be under Frankie, won't it?
Karma,
Frank,
that's the one. Dragged up, never had a chance. Cutting down the back street with a bag of plants. Wanna sign Big Frank, that's a mad advance. Baggy jeans with a whap, do the hammer dance. Bag of bars. Pagan saying that I'm dead, mate, I haven't asked. Fam, I'll make it rain, it's an avalanche. Big taser like I'm working on a cattle ranch.
Jeez, sounds like XP, Frank here with Karma.
Hard.
Big chat. His flow's always been like, it's just been different for me. XP's always been one that when he drops, you listen, you pay attention to, you make a point of checking
Punchline King, bro.
Yeah, 100. Is there anyone in Manchester like that you've not worked with yet that you'd like to work with? Who should come down to Lab 51 and come and work with you guys?
XP's actually not been yet. we've been doing it over the email, so he's gonna come. I'd like to get. We mentioned it on Behind the Mic. I'd like to work with Shotty Horror. I'd like to get him on the channel.
Yeah.
Definitely. Obviously, I'd like to get Shifty on there, bro, but we'll see. There's a... I don't know, man.
Dr. G, right?
Dr. G. Yeah, but I'm thinking of artists here. I'd like to get Dr. G on Behind the Mic, definitely. There's a lot who I'd like to work with. And in terms of me as an artist, bro, I'd like to work with XP as well. We've talked about that.
Just
one sec, bro. My niece keeps texting me, telling me to shout her out. So, all tight, Renee. You're happening. You're getting bombs dropped and all sorts.
There you go. How's that, Renee? All tight, Renee.
All tight, Renee. Did you get enough time to get your phone out then, kid? You filming it here? All tight, Renee and Keely, man. Yeah, she'll be laughing her head off somewhere now. I'll get tagged on the story in a minute.
Jeez, okay, I hear that. So Lab 51, yo, we're in the building. If anyone wants to get involved with you at Lab 51, where can they go to get involved?
Obviously, they can hit us up on the gram, the Lab 51, at Lab 51, or my personal, at Official Samzy, but I'd advise you, go through the Lab 51 channel, innit? It's tailored to what you want,
you know what I mean?
But if it take a while to get back at it, it's not ignorant. We all know how our inboxes are at the moment. We've all these daft spam channels and all sorts, so you know, you can get lost in the mix sometimes.
Yes, it has been a bit mad recently, too many. Mind you, mine's been quiet for a while now, none of that daftness come through. It was Britters and Kane, funny enough, talk about Britters and Kane before I was with him, and he was getting loads of that, oh, you've won this gift giveaway, da da da.
Frustrating.
So, like, I said, whoa, he said, block them all. And report them all as well. So just click report and get rid of them all, innit? Yeah. And ever since I started doing that, board, he stopped.
Go on. Frustrating,
man. Coming through, man. Well, yeah, Unity Radio 92.8 FM. This is your Instagram hack channel. Jeez. So, Lab 51. No, it's nice to have you in the building, man.
I appreciate it, bro. As well, what I have brought in the music, bro. Because obviously, like you said, we're touching on Samzy. There's a couple more tracks yet we can spin. But I brought some of the older stuff.
Right,
what a track we can get into next call, This Is The Life, because obviously from listening to that Lab session, and obviously we'll end on the other Lab session at some point whenever we finish the show, we'll play this track now. It's off my first mixtape. It's called This Is The Life. It features Alfonio and Reeks. So you'll hear the transition, you'll hear the difference in what I'm talking about, where I've been, you know, and the growth as an artist, as a man. So yeah, man, if you want to spin that next, bro.
So when was this track out, you say? Is this one of the older ones?
One of the very first, yeah, my very first mixtape. It's probably touching 10 years old, probably.
Right, okay,
probably
okay,
more,
okay.
You know, because YouTube, obviously, we uploaded it way after it got recorded and that. It was actually recorded in that studio when I had it green at the back, you know, that one that used to be there. I don't know if it still is. It's not open like that if it is, innit? But yeah, man, it was a long time ago it got recorded. But it was popular when it got released. It was on the channel TMTV, and he deleted his channel for one reason.
I remember TMTV.
But me, I'm a guy that I like to keep documents of everything I've got in it, so I kept a copy of that video, so I re-uploaded it a few years ago on my own channel. So yeah, man, it's there if anyone wants to look in. But it's an old song. The quality's not the best, but it slaps in it.
The vibe's there.
The vibe's there, bro.
Yo, let's go. This is Sam's air feature. In fact, I'll let you intro this one.
Me intro it. This is Sam's.
Can we intro it like as Sam's from 10 years ago?
Nah, bro. A lot's changed then. My voice is broke.
Right, okay.
The nicest way to put it. I sounded a lot squeakier then, but yeah, man, this is Sam's. This is The Life featuring Alfonio and the Reeks.
This is the life that we be living. Caught in the hype, we trapped up in it. The front line where we reside, right by the finish. We be risking it off when we know there's no winning. This is the life that we be living. Caught in the hype, we trapped up in it. The front line where we reside, right by the finish. We be risking it off when we know there's no winning.
Label me as a G to my dying days. Hearts in the game, but still I'm trying to find my way. So I'm stuck up in the game like it's mad traffic. Yeah. And I gotta get the guap, it's a mad habit. Yeah. Niggas do, some niggas want.
Jeez, okay, Sansi, I see ya. I love the sample in this one.
It's nice, isn't it?
Hard.
My guy Weezy Brown, bro, from London, him and Westy it was.
Now, that's a big track, and like you say, what's that, 10 years old now? Love that.
It's catchy, innit? It's got that vibe.
Yeah, 100. Yeah. There's also like a little element of Beverly Hills Cop in there for me, with that beat and that. Like,
okay.
One of my favourite UK rappers at the moment is Cass Is Dead. Like,
okay.
Because some of the tracks they put out, I don't know, just got that 80s vibe on it.
It's just
a little bit different. About
I know exactly what you mean.
And that, it just kind of, it's one of those beats, I think, like, yeah, I could picture Castle something like
that. I was actually thinking of him the other day, bro, and I was saying, I'm trying to think of an artist who this kid reminds me of. Someone uploaded to the channel, that was the artist.
But I couldn't get his name.
Exactly who I was thinking of. I know he's got his own unique vibe.
Yeah, 100. Who are you listening to at the moment, speaking of Castle's dad?
Who am I listening to, bro? Do you know what, bro? At the moment, bro, I'm listening to, like, some old school stuff. My playlist at the moment, bro, on the way to it, I always play, because it's the beginning of my playlist and it always ends at the same time. You know that Womack on Womack track?
Yeah.
Teardrops?
We've got the
Fleetwood Mac on there. Got a little bit Everything But The Girl. You remember that song?
Yeah, 100%.
Bro, like, my playlist is mad, just because I listen to rap, bro. I feel that makes me a better rapper, bro, because I'm not stuck on let's listen to rap.
Yeah.
And it helps to me to discover and dabble around with different beats. Like, I'll hear something and be like, oh, can we spin that? You know, with engineers in the past, I want to turn that into a rap song.
Well, that's what rap's always been built on. It's always been built on stealing and sort of sampling from other
literally
spots and you know what I mean, using different loops, but doing it in a creative way and flipping it up and changing it. Like, that's what we've built on, DIY culture.
Yeah, of course.
So we got a couple more tracks for yourself to run into this evening. What's the next track we're going to get into? T357, you say,
yeah,
LT?
Yeah. Let's run with my guy, LT. He's not around at the moment, but when he lands, he's got some work to put in,
because
he'll be in the studio with us. So yeah, shout out LT357. Not been rapping long, but he's going to be a problem when he lands, man.
So is this track a fresh track, or is this a few years old?
This is out. It came out a few months ago. It's on the strip. LT357 on the strip. The second, with that series there, we started with Tiny Boost. LT357 followed him up on that series, and that's all we've released on that series for now. We'll get into Tiny Boost in a little bit as well.
Right, okay.
But yeah, my next one's LT35.
Let's get into it. Unity Radio 92.8 FM. This is LT357. This is On The Strip. Let's go.
Hey, yo, sweetie, that one going crazy. Loch.
I've got to cover me facing pictures, cause nowadays there's too many snitches. And I begin to feel till I'm rich, kid, if I robbed you, just know it was business. When I see a couple kids, they're finished, straight on sight, I turn them to victims. Anytime that I've been in the kitchen, just know I weren't doing no dishes. I've got to cover me facing pictures, cause nowadays there's too many snitches. And I begin to feel till I'm rich, kid, if I robbed you, just know it was business. When I see a couple kids, they're finished, straight on sight, I turn them to victims. Anytime that I've been in the kitchen, just know I weren't doing no dishes. Just a kid going scot.
LT357. That's honest truth. So how did you link up with LT357?
He's a mate of mine, you know, bro. Funny enough, I've got a friend from London called Emrox, who's an artist, and he come down, shot a track. We filmed a recorded a song called Flintstone, shot a video to it. And LT is his cousin, innit? So he said, I'll get my cousins down from Runcorn. They'll all come down on the bikes and that. And we just built a friendship off the back of that one occasion. And then he started writing, bro, when he went to jail, and he was just hard. Me and Reeks was like, nah, bro, you need to start taking it serious. And that got sent out and sent back and forth like they do these days.
I think that's how a lot of crews, a lot of music relationships get built at the moment. Yeah. Like, a lot of people become friends through the passion, and I know a lot of people that have worked on music together, like they've gotten so well and the tracks have come out good, and then before you know it, that's it, then they're just friends from
that's
that moment.
That's it, bro,
like,
yeah.
I love the Manchester music scene that we have here. I think it's so kind of wide and diverse, and right now it only seems to be getting stronger. Obviously, we've got people like Meeks, we've got Tundee, who's going to be doing his tour soon. We've got like Church and Azusa, and you've got like DRS and the Eagle Wings Band, like a kind of that drum and bass type of vibe. We were talking earlier about multi-genres and making sure that we kind of step out and try and do things that maybe you're not too comfortable with.
Yeah,
is there a genre that you've not done yet at Lab 51 that you'd like to step into a little bit and try and do maybe a different wave of music?
Yeah, bro, like I'm open to it all, me, bro. Like, it's a case of, it's nice when someone moves towards with like, yo, I do this, yeah, okay, let's work in it. Like,
yeah, yeah,
we've talked about maybe doing some acoustic sessions.
Right, okay.
So maybe getting a bit of a band in, you know, and getting some artists in, not necessarily just rappers, whether you're a vocalist, R&B singer, whichever. We've talked about doing a bit of stuff like that. And it'd be nice to just get someone a rock and roll guy goes rolling and just shut down the dance or something different.
Yeah,
funny enough, there's a lab session deep in the channel, bro, with a fella on his guitar, he's an indie artist.
Right, okay.
When we very first started, and I just was reached out, I want something different, Nicky.
Yeah.
I can't even remember his name, bro. And he's done an a cappella, bro.
I like acoustic sessions. I think acoustic sessions, like, for me, they put the artist in a real life situation, like, strip away the studio, strip away this expensive mic, get your compressor out.
Yeah,
there,
man.
You know, it's just you rock and the guitar, let me hear what you've got. I think sometimes it's a big testament to artists if they can do a live acoustic session. Dream guest, Lab 51 dream guest.
Dream guest?
Like, sky's the limit, dream guest, who would you want? You can give me a few if you want, you don't have to give me one.
Gigs, from the UK, Gigs.
Love Gigs, his new
gotta
album.
Gotta be Gigs, bro.
Zero Tolerance, have you heard the new album?
No, I'm not going to lie, I'm not even tuned into it, bro.
I love it already, you know.
I'm still listening to his old stuff. Taking me a while to get to his new stuff, but I'm just hooked on the old stuff.
Yeah, I hear that. All this new album, Dave East is on it.
Yeah.
Jada Kiss is on it. Dave's on it. Like, whoa, the album's hard, man.
I heard that thing he did with Diddy.
Yeah. Mandem.
Yeah. But nah, bro, listen to the old stuff. So yeah, Gigs, UK. Bro, I'd like some of the old boys, West Coast rappers. I'm going to get people like X-Rated and Big Tone and that on there.
Okay,
they're coming on
okay,
the channel, innit?
Okay,
because I'm going to make it happen, bro.
Big shout.
I want to get
shout.
Money in there, and I intend on doing so. One way or another, it'll happen, innit?
Two words for you. Dr. G.
There you go, Dr. G. He's
there's
the man for this.
There's your link for that.
So all of them sort of guys, like, I'm a big fan of the underground stuff. I like the stuff everyone listens to on the radio. Like, I like Dirk and people like that.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? But like, they don't excite me as much as these underground rappers do. Do you know what I'm saying? There was a time when Dirk would have been underground, but for me...
Why is that? Because it's more raw? Do you think it's more real? Or?
So, I'm just going back to what I always listen to from the start. and they was my first go-to guys. Were they Big Tom, Brady, G-Mac, Flipping, you know, even
Brother Lynch.
Yeah, yeah. Back to 3-6, my friend. Some of it I listened to now, I don't think. I used to listen to this. mustn't have been paying attention to what they were saying because it's a bit, oh, a bit crazy, but you know what I'm saying, them horrorcore guys.
ICP and all that type of stuff.
Yeah, a bit mad, innit? But music's art, innit? I don't know whatever they're talking, but bro, this stuff, it's going to be some underground. Damn, Big Tone definitely in it. I like what he's doing now and the way he's grown in it. Like, I feel like I know him personally. I don't, but I feel like I do from him being a rapper and what he was up to when he was younger. Because these are the sort of rappers, bro. These ain't these radio-friendly rappers, bro, that talk. These men are gangbangers first, rappers second. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Not to glorify, but that's what they was.
There's only certain guys that can be gangsters and rappers. Exactly. You see a lot of it. People don't realise it's an entertainment business like that. So I do hear you with those underground guys. I think that's why sometimes the trap to drill kind of style that's out at the minute doesn't get as much radio play or shining light sometimes as it does do, and why it has this kind of negative connotation to it right now. But hip-hop had it, when hip-hop first started, it's only repeated what we're seeing from different genres. We've got rock had it, punk had it, it's nothing new that we're seeing right now. It's just different ages, different times. Different weapons, different message, but it's basically the same sort of thing. Samzy, it's been a pleasure having you in tonight, man. I really enjoyed it. Obviously, we did your Behind the Mic podcast, so that's out there right now. Go and check that if you have a little bit of time. Me and Samzy chopping up about my history, and that was so mad for me as well to like, because I'm normally this side, you know, asking the questions, to be flipped on that side was just, it was nice, man.
It was good, I enjoyed it, bro. And because we didn't know each other, properly, we had our little, you know, we knew each other line and that. It was new to me. You know what I mean? And finding out interesting stuff like Walsh and that, and knew him, other people that knew him. So yeah, it was good, man. I enjoyed it myself.
Yeah, serious. Big shout out. So we got one more track to play for us tonight. What are you going to run with? What's the last tune we're hearing this evening?
So we started on Lab Sessions Part 2. We're doing it backwards. So we'll go in with Lab Sessions Part 1. For any of the young ones listening, I want you to listen carefully to this. Because this is like, I'm reaching out to you lot on this, innit? It's a crazy world at the moment for the young ones coming up, man. Do you know what I'm saying? So, yeah, it's a scary place to be at, you know, when you're a young teenager, the madness that's going on. Not what it seems, innit? Just listen closely to the music, man, and take from it what you can, innit?
Okay, that seems like a real nice, deep message to kind of end that interview on and end the show with. Yo, Samzy, one more time for the people out there, what are getting in touch with you, what are follow, what's going on at Lab 51, what are seeing more kind of in tune, where can you go, how can you follow, how can you get in touch one more time?
So yeah, man, at Lab 51, on everything, all of the socials, if we're on there, it'll be Lab 51, the YouTube's Lab 51, keep it simple, and the same with my personal, Official Samzy, on any social network I'm on, it'll be Official Samzy.
This is Samzy. This is Lab Session Official. This is was this the first video up on the channel, sorry?
Nah, Shreds was the first Lab Session, shout Shreds, but this was my first Lab Sessions on the channel. Right. I ended season 2 at the old studio before we collapsed it and moved into the new space. So yeah, man, it means a lot, man.
Big shout, Samzy, Lab Session, let's go.
Samzy, listen to me, I want you young ones to take this one on board, you know. I got a story to tell. You need to listen to my reeks, tell him.
I run all that, yo. My boy's on the phone riding, wanna let him tell him, yo.
Yeah, come on, bro, just ride and bang up 9 months in, just under 3 years left, man, soon, oh.
Yeah, man, 3 to 57.
Looking back, how did I make it up? How many times did I fought with no one to shout? I could have called my mumsy every single time, but I'm a soldier G, I love her, I didn't want to stress her out. I found my way and kept it moving, I was on the road to ruins. But I hit her, you would slap myself, I promise that I'd make her proud. Look at me now, my first milli ghost, so mum she can buy her and my sister a house. I fuck.